Carlos makes me dive into the danger zone for this one. Smallest number, longest bar. So Carlos wants me to do a data bar where the smallest number is the longest. And look, we have these three conditional formatting tools, and two of them have very easy ways to reverse. The color scales, they actually offer the reverse right there. So small numbers in red, large numbers in red. For the icon sets, you have to go into manage rules, edit the rule, and right here, reverse icon order will let you reverse that. Okay, but for data bars, yeah, there's nothing really built in for this. Okay, so Carlos actually sent me a picture where the bar was outside the cell, so this first one's gonna work for him. I'm gonna come out here to column H, and I'm gonna make those numbers be negative and copy it down. Conditional formatting, data bars, and choose a color here. Now that's not how we want this to look, but we're gonna go into conditional formatting, manage rules, edit the rule, and down here there's something called negative values and axes. And we're gonna say that we want the axis settings to show negative bars in the same direction as positive. And of course they're changing the color. I asked for green bars, I'm getting red, click OK. And let's show bar only, click OK. So now we have the smallest number with the longest bar. All right, how did I do this here? Oh yeah, I hate to even bring this one up because clearly we are going into the danger zone. I'm gonna take those positive numbers, I'm gonna multiply them, Alt-E-S-M to multiply by the negative one that's on the clipboard. Here, we'll do the conditional formatting just like I did before, the data bars. And then we'll go in and manage rules, edit the rule, negative value and axis set to none, click OK. This time I'll show the numbers, click OK. Click OK, and then Control 1 to format those cells, and a custom number format that says for positive numbers we want no negative sign, and for negative numbers we want no negative sign. So 0, semicolon 0. Boy, this is really dangerous because someone in the future is going to think that those numbers should add up to something like 65. But in fact, it's negative 65. So if you ever do any kind of math here, I can see where it would be a bad error. But it gives us the look that Carlos was looking for. All right, there you go. A couple of ways to reverse the data bars, basically by converting them to negative. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.